Should you be concerned about vitamin B12 deficiency?
If you answer yes to any of the following questions, you are either at the risk for vitamin B12 deficiency or you already have vitamin B12 deficiency and you may not even know it. So, what are the questions?
Are you vegan? Do you take any antacid medication? Or do you have diabetes and take medication called metformin? Do you smoke? Do you drink alcohol? Do you have a bad heartburn? How about Crohn's disease or celiac disease? Or do you have any history of gastric bypass surgery? If you said yes to any of these, there is a chance that you may have vitamin B12 deficiency. But you say, I don't feel anything. You are right, you may not feel anything initially and still have vitamin B12 deficiency. The noticeable symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency that we will cover in a bit can show up much later. But wait a minute, don't panic yet. Just because you don't eat meat for a few days, smoke few cigarettes, or have a few beers a week will not make you necessarily vitamin B12 deficient. If your diet is semi-decent and you are not heavy alcoholic, it would take usually up to several years to develop vitamin B12 deficiency. That's because our body has great ability to store vitamin B12, so it's impossible to get vitamin B12 deficiency overnight just because you suddenly change your diet or lifestyle. We will talk about different forms of vitamin B12 for supplementation and if there is really meaningful difference between them, as well as the big argument if you should get a vitamin B12 injection or simply take vitamin B12 pill. But let's first see what are some of the symptoms that you may experience with vitamin B12 deficiency if you said yes to any of the above questions. So one of the first and probably most common symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency is feeling of fatigue and weakness. Now that's because vitamin B12 deficiency prevents your body from making enough red blood cells. So basically, you are developing a form of anemia. Now some people may develop inflammation of the tongue and mouth ulcers as the first signs of B12 deficiency. Later on, when the vitamin B12 deficiency becomes more serious, people will start developing some neurological symptoms, such as sensation of pins and needles. They may feel this tingling or numbness, especially in their hands and feet, and develop a condition called peripheral neuropathy. That's because you need vitamin B12 to protect your nerves. B12 helps to create a protective shield called myelin sheath around the nerves to insulate it. So long-term vitamin B12 deficiency causes loss of the protective sheath and exposes the nerves. This leads to the tingling and pins and needle sensation. If this doesn't get corrected, people start developing more serious symptoms such as difficulty walking, balance problems, and cognitive changes such as memory loss, confusion, and difficulty concentrating. All of that is happening because more and more nerves are getting damaged and the damage is now moving more from periphery, the hands and feet, into the spinal cord and brain. Great, so what do we do about it? Well, obviously, if you drink or smoke heavily, the first thing to do is to get help and get out of it, because you will eventually have a lot more problems than vitamin B12 deficiency. But when it comes to supplementation, lots of people immediately think about B12 injections. I had some people asking me about that, saying that it gives them instantly energy boost. So are the injections better than vitamin B12 pills? Now there are actually three ways you can get vitamin B12 into your body. The best way is obviously food. You can find vitamin B12 primarily in animal-derived products such as meats, dairy products, eggs, and fish. So you may ask, do I have to eat food high in vitamin B12 every day to prevent becoming deficient in vitamin B12? The answer is no. The main reason is that the body is very good at storing vitamin B12 in our liver, creating sufficient stores of vitamin B12 for up to several years. But what if you are vegetarian or vegan? Well, in that case, you either need to rely on food that is fortified with vitamin B12 or what I generally suggest is to use a multivitamin specifically designated for vegans or vegetarians to make sure that you also get other vitamins and minerals that you may not be getting enough of because of your diet, right? But that is up to you. Now, if you are diabetic and take a metformin to control blood sugar, in about 1 year after you start taking metformin, you might start developing vitamin B12 deficiency. And that's because metformin interferes with absorption of vitamin B12. In this case, it is a good idea to not only start having your vitamin B12 level checked regularly, but also to take daily vitamin B12 supplement. The same goes for people who take antacids. Now, you need stomach acid to absorb vitamin B12. So if you are constantly suppressing the production of stomach acid, you will not be absorbing vitamin B12 from your food very efficiently. And eventually, you will deplete the stores of vitamin B12 in your body. That being said, if you can get your acid reflux under control with diet and need daily antacids for a long time, a multivitamin containing B12 might be helpful. But if you only take antacids occasionally and you have in your diet the above foods that are high in vitamin B12, you don't necessarily need extra vitamin B12 supplement. The caveat is that if you have heartburn all the time and you can't control it with diet, you should talk to your healthcare provider to get tested for what's called H. pylori, which is a bacteria that can be present in your stomach and manifest as heartburn. If you test positive for the bacteria, you will need antibiotics to get rid of it. That's important because besides many other problems that H. pylori causes, it also interferes with vitamin B12 absorption. Now, I won't get deeply into the rare autoimmune condition known as pernicious anemia, which leads to vitamin B12 deficiency. This is primarily because it's a relatively rare condition. Basically, what happens is that in pernicious anemia, the body doesn't have important protein called intrinsic factor. The intrinsic factor is produced by stomach cells, and it is really essential for the vitamin B12 absorption. So without it, the body cannot effectively absorb the vitamin B12. But let's get back into the vitamin B12 injections. So, vitamin B12 shot or the pill? Look, studies have clearly shown that there is no difference in effectiveness between getting the vitamin B12 injection or taking vitamin B12 pill in majority of cases. That's because even if you have poor absorption of vitamin B12, you can still get the vitamin B12 into your body through passive diffusion in the intestines. Basically, the high concentration of vitamin B12 from the supplement will seep through the intestinal walls and get into your body. The only time that vitamin B12 injections might be preferred is if you have very severe vitamin B12 deficiency and you need to replenish the vitamin B12 really fast. But after that, to just maintain the vitamin B12 levels, you can save yourself money, the discomfort, and time going to see a provider and just take the daily pill. You get the same results. I will leave the link to that study that discusses that in the description below. Now, one important note is that if you are taking vitamin B12 to correct deficiency, you will need to have your blood work checked to see if it works. In general, you can see changes in the correction of anemia from a couple of weeks to about a month. So rechecking in 1 month is reasonable. To see the difference in neurological symptoms may take longer and it's a more gradual process. It may take even several months to start seeing some changes. Depends on how severe the damage has been. So what is the best form of vitamin B12 supplements? There are several forms of vitamin B12. But for most people, the synthetic form, cyanocobalamin, offers the best balance between cost and effectiveness. This is the form of vitamin B12 that you find in most supplements and fortified food. It is well absorbed and has the advantage of long shelf life. Now, some individuals may have difficulties metabolizing cyanocobalamin, and for these individuals, the methylcobalamin is a better choice. That's because methylcobalamin is one of the active forms of vitamin B12 used directly by the body. Unlike cyanocobalamin that we just mentioned, which needs to be converted into the methylcobalamin to be used effectively. The methylcobalamin just bypasses this conversion step. Now, how do you know if you are one of the people who does not effectively convert cyanocobalamin into the active form of methylcobalamin? Well, you can't really tell unless you don't respond to the supplementation with a standard vitamin B12 form, the cyanocobalamin. The only other way is to do genetic testing, since mutation in the MTHFR gene can affect how well the body processes B12. But even though the genetic testing can identify this mutation, this testing is generally not done routinely. So if you are really concerned, just take the methylcobalamin form of vitamin B12 and you're done. Now, I will also point out that the methylcobalamin form of vitamin B12 is preferred if you have neurological complications from the vitamin B12 deficiency, such as neuropathy. And that's because the methylcobalamin is active form and it works a little bit better than the cyanocobalamin in these cases, based on several studies, but it's still not very conclusive. So pick your battle. Now, can you develop toxicity from taking too much vitamin B12? Vitamin B12 is water soluble and generally has very low toxicity, even in high doses when taken as a supplement. So it's pretty unheard to get toxicity from taking vitamin B12, and it's kind of unheardable to get it from eating too much food high in vitamin B12. Basically, it doesn't happen. So that's all I have for today. If you want more detailed information about vitamin B12, and if you want to know if there is any benefit of taking the B12 injections to boost your energy level, head to our website and subscribe to our newsletter. I'll email you the PDF and also some other perks that you will get as a valuable subscriber to our weekly newsletter.